Okay, today we're talking about some more difficult factoring. So if you're going to factor this problem, first of all, I'd look for a GCF. I'd look for anything that they all have in common, a greatest common factor. Since I don't see any number that they all have in common or any variable, then I'm going to take the approach of setting up two sets of parentheses to see if I can get a FOIL, a first outside inside last multiplication of these two binomials. That would give me this expression. All right, so I need a 2x and an x, because that times that makes these to equal that. And then I do the outside and the inside multiply to make negative 5, and that's really important. And this negative 12 here, it tells me these two numbers have to multiply to negative 12. So I honestly don't know what they are right now. You'll see me guess and try something. So let's say I think it's 6 and 2. Let's say I put a 6 here and a 2 here, and I make it negative 6 and positive 2. Well, then the outside would be positive 4, and the inside would be negative 6. Together, that makes negative 2, and that's not even close to 5. So I'm going to reverse the 6 and the 2 and put a 6 here and 2 here. Then I have 2 times 6 is 12 minus 2 makes 10, also not equal to negative 5. So now I don't think it's even 6 and 2 anymore. So now I'm going to try something else, 4 and 3. Take a 4 here and a 3 here. Now the outside is going to make positive 6. The inside makes negative 4. 6 minus 4 would be 2, and that's not close to 5. So I'm going to reverse them again. The 4 goes here, and the 3 goes here. So now the outside's 8 and the inside's 3. Ooh, that can make a 5. Let me double check that. That's positive 8x and negative 3x, that makes positive 5x. That's the exact opposite of what I wanted. So then I switch the signs from a minus to a plus, and from a plus over here to a minus. There we go. It's factored. That's a whole lot of guessing and checking. But we're not going to try to teach you the other method. It takes a long time, and we personally feel like this practice on the first outside, inside, last is good for you. So, all right, now let's do another one like that. This one does have a GCF because, see, there's a 2 in everything. So the 2 gets factored out to the front, and then I have x squared plus 7x plus, I'm dividing 24 by 2, and I get 12. Then my factors break down like this, x and x to make the x squared. And then two things that multiply to 12 go here and here, and they have to also add up to 7. So I know 4 and 3 do that, 4 and 3, and I double check it by doing the first make x and x make x squared, the outside and the inside make a total of 7x, and the last make 12. Yay, I've got it. I hope you're catching on to the process that we use here. All right, let's do one more, and this one has a 3 in common. Everything has a 3 in it, so it's called the GCF. The 3 factors out, I have 2x squared, and then plus 7x, and then minus 4. And then I go to factor it again, and this must be 2x and x to make 2x squared. And then I need two numbers here and here that will multiply to make negative 4. So it's either a 4 and a 1 or a 2 and a 2. I'm going to go with a 4 and a 1. If I put the 4 here and the 1 here, one of them has to be negative. I'll just guess and go like this, and I'll check. Now, did I get it right? The outside makes positive 8, inside makes negative 1. That makes positive 7x. Yay! And the last make negative 4, so it worked. And there, I've got it factored. That's factoring more difficult expressions.